So today we are going to turn this Eevee render into this by only changing the render settings, adding specific lighting to our scene, and changing the materials with special shader nodes. Let's go. First off, we want to improve our render settings, and I'm not talking about increasing the number of samples. The first three small improvements are very easy. We're going to turn on ambient occlusion. As you can see, this simulates the absence of light. Later in this video, we are going to go deeper into adding ambient occlusion into our scene. Next, we're going to turn on bloom. This will create a nice soft bloom around any lights in our scene. And we will also turn on screen space reflections, which will create reflections in any objects of which the materials are reflective. For higher quality reflections, turn off half res trace. If we would render our scene right now, you can already see some small improvements. You can already see the ambient occlusion working in the corners where there is a lack of light, and you can also see that we now have proper reflections. Next, we're going to increase the resolution of our shadows. Click on Shadows and increase the values of the cube and cascade size to 2K or 4K resolution. Also, turn on High Bit Depth. The better shadow resolution is barely visible at this point, but it will be worth it in the end. Now we're going to add more ambient occlusion into our scene. Open the materials of the objects which intersect or are close to other objects in the shader editor. We are going to add an ambient occlusion node with a color ramp and a mix RGB node. Make sure that your mix RGB node is set to multiply. Connect them like this and slide with the color ramp until the ambient occlusion looks realistic. You can see that the ambient occlusion is now a lot more noticeable. This will make our scene look a lot more realistic and also a lot better. Now we are going to make our scene look more cinematic by adding volumetric fog into our scene. Open the world output in the shader editor and add a principal volume to the world output. Set the density of the principal volume somewhere between 0.005 or 0.01. Now our scene looks a lot better. It is possible that when you do this, your scene will look very dark. If that's the case, you will need to add more lights into your scene. I always add one area or spotlight in the scene to recreate the fog effect of the lighting. I will also add one more normal point light in the scene to light the surrounding scenery. In the light panel of your lights, you can choose if your light is affecting the volumetric fog or not. This will make it very easy to hide lights in your scene without seeing their foggy light rays. You can also choose to link lights with each other by pressing Ctrl L Link Object Data. Now, when you change the lighting in your scene, you can just change one single light and all of the other lights will also change. With the added volumetric fog and extra lights, our scene becomes a lot more cinematic. Finally, we're going to add a 360-degree HDRI environment texture. We do this by adding an environment texture node to our surface world in the shader editor. You can download hundreds of free HDRIs on polyhaven.com, which I also will be using. I chose this HDRI. If you add a mapping and a texture coordinate node after your environment texture, you can rotate your HDRI around. I color corrected the HDRI with simple color nodes to make it look more realistic in our scene. With the HDRI added, it feels as if there is another world besides the parking garage. And with the color correction, it looks also realistic.